Oh. Well, that was fun, wasn't it?
What, you fairy?
Oh, hello, sailor.
No, you wouldn't have got on one of our voyages. They were all dead bush.
That's not what I've heard.
There is an epic quality about the sea, which has throughout history stirred the hearts and minds of Englishmen of all nations. Sir Francis Drake, Captain Webb, Nelson of Trafalgar, and Scott of the Antarctic all rose to the challenge of the mighty ocean. And today, another Englishman may add his name to the golden roll of history, Mr. Ron Obvious of Neep's End. For today, Ron Obvious hopes to be the first man to jump the channel.
Ron, let's just get this quite clear. You're intending to jump across the English Channel.
Oh, yes, that is correct, yes.
And just how far is that?
Oh, well, it's 26 miles from here to Calais.
That's to the beach at Calais.
Well, no, provided I get a good lift off and maybe a gust of breeze over the French coast, I shall be jumping into the centre of Calais itself.
Ron, are you using any special techniques to jump this great distance?
Oh, no, I shall be using an ordinary two-footed jump straight up in the air and across the channel.
I see. Ron, what is the furthest distance that you've jumped so far?
11 foot 6 inches at Motspur Park on July the 22nd. But I have done nearly 12 feet unofficially.
I see. Ron, aren't you worried, Ron? Aren't you worried jumping 26 miles across the sea?
Oh, no. It is, in fact, easier to jump over sea than over dry land.
Well, how is that?
My manager explained it to me. You see, if you're 5 miles out over the English Channel with nothing but sea underneath you, there's a very great impetus to stay in the air.
I see. Well, thank you very much, Ron, and the very best of luck.
Thank you.
The man behind Ron's cross-channel jump is his manager, Mr. Luigi Facotti. Mr. Facotti.
What? Hold on, I've never been down the old Coca Club, I don't know what you're talking about.
We're from the BBC, Mr. Facotti.
Who?
The BBC.
Oh, see. I thought you were the I like the police a lot. Got a lot of
yes.
Time.
Well, Mr. Facotti, what is your chief task as Ron's manager?
Well, my main task is to fix a sponsor for the big jump.
And who is the sponsor?
The Chipman and Brick Company. They pay all the bills. In return for which, Ron will be carrying half a hundredweight of their bricks.
I see. Well, it looks as if Ron is ready now. He's got the bricks, he's had his passport checked, and he's all set to go. And he's off on the first ever cross-channel jump. Will Ron be trying the cross-channel jump again soon?
No, I'm taking him off the jumps because I've got something lined up for Ron next week that I think is very much more up his street.
What's that?
Ron is going to eat Chichester Cathedral.
Well, there he goes, Ron Obvious of Neep's End, in an attempt which could make him the first man ever to eat an entire Anglican cathedral.
David, this is something which both Ron and myself are really keen on. Ron is going to tunnel from Godalming here to Java here.
Java?
Yeah, I personally think this is going to make Ron a household name overnight.
And how far has he got?
Well, he's quite far now, Dave. Well on the way. Well on the way, yeah.
Well, where is he exactly?
Yeah.
Where?
Well, it's difficult to say exactly. He's, in the area of, Ron, how far have you got?
2'6", Mr.
McCotty. Well, keep digging, lad, keep digging.
McCotty, are you sure there isn't a spade?
Mr. Facotti, what do you say to people who accuse you of exploiting Ron for your own purposes?
Why, it's totally untrue, David. Ever since I left Sicily, I've been trying to do the best for Ron. I know what Ron wants to do, I believe in him. And I'm just trying to create the opportunities for Ron to do the kind of things he wants to do.
And what's he going to do today?
He's going to split a railway carriage with his nose. The only difficult bit for Ron is getting out of Earth's atmosphere. Once he's in orbit, he'll be able to run straight to Mercury.
I am now extremely hopeful that Ron will break the world record for remaining underground. He's a wonderful boy, this. He's got this really enormous talent, this really huge talent.
That's a bit sad, isn't it? Shh, it's satire. No, it isn't. This is zany madcap humour.